Okay, now let's bring on Patrick Howley. I'll pull up the speech as well.
Underwood, the gentlewoman from Texas.
They're reading out some bullshit. I just saw the ghoul, Schumer. Now let me unmute the tab here, and I'm gonna have to put you on the screen along with the speech. I have to do it a little bit differently, so they can't see you yet, but they can hear you. How you doing, Patrick? Sorry, I had to keep you waiting there for just a minute.
Ethan Ralph, it's good to hear from you, my friend. What's the latest with you? Down in Mexico, there's chaos, right? The presidential palace got stormed?
You saw that? Yeah, you saw that. Yeah, they beat in the door of the presidential palace yesterday. And for those who don't know, there was students abducted. Student abduction. Let me see if I can look this up real quick. But so there was a massacre of students. Allegedly, I don't know, back in before the 68 Olympics in Mexico City, and a bunch of them got killed, allegedly, or whatever. And so in 2014, some students, I guess it was like an annual tradition, they would hijack a bus, based commandeer kind of, nonviolently, and then they would go to the site of the massacre or whatever and do a protest. Well, they did that in 2014, and then the bus got commandeered by either the police or some other organization, depending on which story you believe. Anyway, all those students got killed in 2014, and there's never really been a reckoning about it. And so in Mexico, it's a big deal, and so they were protesting that yesterday.
Yeah, I was wondering
James
if that was you.
No. Fuck these people.
But did you notice that Mike Johnson? He has a very large nose, and I think the reason for that is obviously because he lies like Pinocchio, because he's a little middle manager for the establishments, and his nose just gets bigger as he lies. I think that's the reason, maybe.
I haven't been impressed with him. Let's just put it that way.
Big Israel supporter. He likes Israel.
Yeah, he literally is. Okay, now let me see. I'm going to try to pull you up on the screen.
Now, remember, we did the 22 Days of Chaos. I wasn't about to try to sell the 22 Days of Chaos for, Mike Johnson, which was ultimately Matt Gaetz's decision. I disagree with him. He knows that. I'm a chaos agent, right?
Right.
Whereas Matt Gaetz... he has to be a congressman, but I would have kept it going. 900 days of chaos. Why not? You know,
that's kind of what I wanted to see. I mean, yeah, you're right though. At the end of the day, he still is a congressman. He wants to be governor of Florida as well. And so unfortunately, probably via, his calculations, like, oh, I can only go so far with it. Right. I got to play ball a little bit.
I disagree though. I would just go forever. Like, we don't need a House of Representatives. It just signs off on the spending, and the spending goes to Zelensky, of course. And if Mike Johnson even considers passing this $95.3 billion bill for World War III, he's going to get vacated one way or another. I think Eli Crane might be the one to do it, to bring up the motion to vacate if Matt Gaetz won't do it again.
Well, they've been threatening to do that, by the way. And thank you, James Gardner. He sent a 20 spot in Super Chat, and he said, fuck these people. A warm welcome to the guest. A warm welcome indeed. Killstream Hall of Famer here, Patrick Howley. Also, have you seen the Democratic ladies of the night wearing their all white?
Not in years, Ralph. I'm a Christian.
Not literally. I mean, I'm talking about these Congress whores out here. They're, they, of course, they don't do that Lady of the Night thing down here in Mexico. But what do you think? They're wearing white, I guess, for reproductive rights or something like that. I don't think most of these ladies are qualified to wear white. But
no, wearing white is a symbol of a virginal kind of aesthetic, not that's a killing babies kind of aesthetic.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said. They're bringing out the Supreme Court now, as you can see live. I have the C-SPAN feed pulled up, so I think you have the same one because I sent it to you. Thoughts on the Supreme Court at all? Their recent intervention, the left's been spurging out about the Supreme Court.
I'd like to get one of those seats, no offense to Kintanji, but I'd like to get one of those seats. That's pretty big. So, obviously I'm still bitter because Trump's three Supreme Court justices wouldn't hear our case challenging the 2020 election. Only Alito and Thomas would even hear it. But yet again, you have Trump making the historic decision to, appoint three justices in the first place. So he's, the Republicans are sitting pretty when it comes to that. You know, obviously you saw Roe v. Wade finally get rolled back. So Trump, you know, so apparently Biden's going to talk about how he wants to raise taxes. That's his big thing. If that's the trailer, I can't wait for the movie, folks.
Please. Well, if he does that, he's probably going to lose anyway, looking like. But he definitely
he's
going to
raise corporate taxes. He's gonna ramble about how it's the fat cats who he's fighting against because he's Lunch Pail Joe. There's Ketanji right there.
Yes, she's looking like something else. Yeah. That's her actual hair. It looks like she has one of those... like helmet
sends you to detention.
Yeah. Biden's still not out. They were showing the cars. Oh, Kagan, Jesus. Kagan looking rough. Holy fuck. Gender bending Kagan there. That's a rough
as opposed to usual when Kagan's like super hot, right?
That's right. Yeah, she was always a real piece of work, as Trump would say. But
seen Elena Kagan today? Hey, she's no yelling. See, the hopeful thing is I'm only 34, Ralph. I still have 50 years until I hit my DC political prime.
So that's true.
I'm just an infant in this business.
That's true. Plenty of time for Senate and everything else. Yeah. Now, let me ask you, Biden said, apparently it's leaked. Sometimes the whole speech leaks before now, but I don't know that it has. I haven't checked everywhere, but I don't think so. But I've been on air, so I may have missed it. But a lot of times the whole entire speech is out by now, but they always leak a few bullet points or whatever. And one of the ones I saw leaked today was that they're going to build a port in Gaza or on the coast of Gaza to get more aid in conjunction with the IDF. Port. Yeah, go ahead.
The Biden port. I don't think that's a good use of spending, man. You know, I don't think you could sell that to the folks down at the grocery store, the Biden port. But basically... you're seeing actually it took the left, not the Republicans, of course, it took the left protesting this war and then Biden losing over 100,000 votes to uncommitted in the Michigan primary. Finally, you started to see the Biden White House talk about they want a ceasefire now. Now they want a ceasefire, a temporary ceasefire between Israel and Gaza. So the pressure basically is working. You know, I've been encouraging anti-war protesters who are mostly, you know, on the other side there, on the progressive side, but at least they're stepping up and getting something done here because we all want, you know, Republicans aren't going to stop this. If Mike Jensen signed off on this, it's just despicable.
Yeah, the Republicans aren't going to stop it, unfortunately. Yeah. And there are some, you know, people in our area of the internet on the right who are against it, et cetera. But you don't see that reflected broadly across the Republican base. And you damn sure don't see it represented amongst the elected Republicans. And, yeah, this uncommitted thing has put a shock into the Biden administration. And they weren't really putting really any pressure on Israel at all until that came about. In Michigan and what was it, Minnesota? Yeah, is that George Santos? What the fuck? What? How is
Who
he there?
Yeah, did somebody bring him as a guest?
He must be. He got expelled.
Maybe it was Phone Party Marco bringing him as a guest.
They did just cut to Marco too right after. He's looking around like he swallowed the
guy on C-SPAN or something. I don't know. We got to get him on.
That was bizarre. I didn't expect to see Santos there tonight.
Yeah.
They said they invited the parents of Lake.
That's my boy Massey. There we go. Massey Gates. You know, there's the cool kids. You know,
there's a few
back of the class.
There's one or two. Massey's probably the biggest example of a guy. Oh, God, Lindsey. Lindsey Graham.
I do declare.
Oh, God.
I don't see his quill pen to write any strongly worded letters.
No, I don't either.
Talking to Susan Collins and Murkowski, of course.
Three of the worst senators, maybe the three worst senators, actually, now that I think about it.
They're like Miranda and Sarah Jessica Parker. She's the one who ran for governor. Redhead. That was an angry
did you
redhead,
see, by the way, when Trump won South Carolina, also Biden's running late, but I saw him walking around the Capitol, so I'm assuming he'll be in there in about 30 minutes whenever he can get his steps going. did you see Lindsey Graham get booed? After Trump won South Carolina, that was one of my favorite moments of the political year so far.
Yeah, it's pretty good, too. You know, so am I like the Steve Kornacki here? Do I have to be like, so, guys, here, we're going to look for some Leslie Nielsen-style slapstick from Biden. Is he going to fall down? Like, there's Josh Hawley with Marco and a little Marco with Ted. Ugh. Whatever happened to Ted Cruz? Remember when he was like popular?
Yeah, I do. Now he might even lose his Senate seat down in Texas. I still think he'll pull it out because presidential year, but it's a close race down there in Texas. Yeah, what are your predictions for the speech? Again, I don't think the full speech is leaked. A lot of times it does, but will Biden even make it through the speech? How long do you think it'll be? I said earlier I don't see it being longer than an hour because I don't think Biden could do that.
I don't know if he's going to be able to hold out. This is pretty rough. He's been in a pretty rough shape lately, but you see Johnson participating in this with that Ho Kamala?
I do.
Johnson looks like Stephen Colbert.
He does. He 100% does look like Colbert. There's Manchin and Romney. Do you think, now there's been some rumors I've read in the press of those two perhaps running on the, what, no labels ticket as an item there, VP and president?
We don't want Mitt.
No, I don't. People get on me. I voted for Obama over Mitt Romney, and some people try to bring that up like as a talking point against me, and I was like, well, I wouldn't vote for Mitt Romney for anything. Now, I could have just not voted for either. That's true, but Mitt Romney is disgusting, and I think that's been proven since then.
Well, they might be switching parties, but Bill and Melinda Gates might have switched genders. I don't know if you've seen both of them lately looking different than before.
Yeah, Melinda is a very handsome woman. Yes,
she's no Janet Yellen though.
And she's so rich. I don't know. Bill, she got in there early, I guess. Of course, they're divorced now, but she had to have gotten in there early. She is really, really strong visage there. really granite faced, I guess. Is how I
like Glenn Close.
Yeah. She looks like her face looks like it was carved on Mount Rushmore or something. You know what I mean? Like
The old man in the mountain.
It's really fucked. There's Bernie Sanders and whatever her name is from Hawaii.
Maisie Hirono.
Yeah. Maisie Hirono.
Hawaiian lady there. All right. Yeah. Pretty cool.
She gives herself away because she wears the whatever the fuck they're called. Fuck, I used to know that.
They look like happening boomers.
Yeah, what are those called? The flower necklace? Fuck. I can't remember the name of those. Somebody in chat's going to fucking get that immediately. But I'm spaced out on what those are called. What are they? A lay? Is that really it? I wouldn't want to lay with her, though. She looks pretty rough. Now, there's Maxine Waters.
Ooh.
How old is she now?
How old are any of them? I mean, I guess it fluctuates depending on whether or not they get
Tommy Tuberville.
Whether they get their nutrients, right?
Yeah, the blood of young children, probably, if I had to guess. But thoughts on Schumer? I saw him creeping around.
No worries there. No, what are my thoughts on Chuck Schumer? Like, rotting parasite, like, barnacle on the sinking ship of America, like, two-bit huckster holding America hostage, trying to kill your grandmother in order to get more war funding, like... I'm not a fan. Not so much.
Chuck Schumer, no problems there. No issue there. What do you mean?
Oh, whatever. I'm sure he's got it under control.
There's Jerry Nadler. Talk about hucksters and old bag of bones.
Pants Jerry. Looking like a penguin.
He used to be really fat. Now, I lost 100 pounds in the last year, but he had the stomach. I did it the honest way. He had the stomach staple surgery. And now he looks like a deflated balloon every time I look at him. And half the time he's passing out, falling asleep.
Al Roker has that.
Yeah, Al Roker has that look, too. Al Sharpton, too, as well. Some people. Okay, now is this the president? Where the fuck is he?
He's at Mar-a-Lago.
Did you see Trump's little video about this? And apparently he might be live.
He is live.
Fact-checking. Fact-checking this. Yeah, live-truthing. That's right. Live-truthing this. I should use my
channel. He's got to get back on Twitter. I mean,
I think, too.
I mean, it's ridiculous. He owes it to his supporters to be on Twitter.
Is it the contract? Well, I read a story that they did a merger. I forget what it's called, the stock market move. There's a term for it, but his company is doing a merger with another company, True Social is. And apparently, no shit, I read this the other day, that will actually net him like $4 or $5 million. This company merger, once it happens, because the stock that he owns will be worth $4 or $5 billion now. He actually needs that money now because of the huge fine they put on.
How does that your inauguration, Donald? Remember, that's your inauguration. VIP room too, with Sheldon Adelson and other.
No favorites. Shit.
Oh man, I'm the Leonard Zelig of American politics, but Gentile. Irish yeah. And Italian. I don't know how you feel about that, but that's what it is.
No, that's great. But, you know, yeah, I meant to bring that up on the show, but I don't know how many people know that story. I forget there's a term for the type of merger that he's doing, but it should net him billions of dollars. So he's not actually going to be broke, but, of course, it hasn't fully went down yet, and he can't sell the stock yet for a certain amount of time, and they may try to take Trump Tower or, what is it, 66 Wall Street.
Trump Tower. We're going to have to go protect that.
Yeah, I think, you know, they might get away with taking 66 Wall Street or whatever the fuck that building name is. But
well, Ivanka had the hotel sold. That's too bad. That's where I used to hang out in D.C. Oh, here's the blues man blinking.
Yeah. I've been to the hotel. Did they close
Harry's?
Yes, they did. I hate that, too. I've been there so many times.
Probably for the best for me as I enter into the redemption and recovery.
Well, I was going to say, I'm sober, but I wasn't sober all those times I went to Harry's.
Think about all the politics. Think of all the populist politics in that smoke-filled room, man. You know?
That's a great fucking place. Yeah, they were closing. They closed it in January, and I've been there many times. Every time I go to D.C., I go to Harry's. And they remember me, too, because I would go up there fairly often. A lot of times I'd be up there.
Not 24 hours anymore, either, in Adams Morgan.
No, it's not.
Scamdemic. And the Capitol Lounge was closed.
Dude, what the fuck?
I don't even know what the hell. I'm like Billy Madison going back to high school, you know?
Dude, COVID fucked everything up as far as like 24 hours and McDonald's was serving breakfast all day before COVID. Remember that? Remember when you could get an Egg McMuffin at like 5:30 p.m.? And then they were like, oh, it's back. You can do that forever now. And then COVID, they took it away from us. 24-hour Walmarts don't exist anymore.
Never forget what they took from us.
Seriously, they took that. Well, you know, I stream a lot. Of course, I'm in Mexico now. Whatever. It doesn't fucking matter. But a lot of times I would go to the store like really late at night, you know, 2, 3 a.m. Those were some of my favorite times to go to Walmart because the fucking people weren't there. It's actually bearable, right?
I don't like going to Walmart. You know, there's a lot of fighting in Walmart. I have a segment on my show called Walmart Fights. And I wanted to do a wrestling special with you, Wildest Walmart Fights. Where you could be like Jim Cornette, or you could be like King Lawler.
I love that. I know both those gentlemen. Yeah,
that'd be pretty good.
Very well. And WrestleMania is right around the corner.
I call that as a DVD, maybe. Yeah, WrestleMania. So what do you think about that? I'm not a Rock fan, so he's a vaccine shill. So I'm going to go with Cody Rhodes.
Cody has to go over. If they don't put Cody over, it's an absolute disgrace. I don't know. If it was me, I don't think Cena's fully available. But I would have Cena.
Story and, for Dusty, man.
Yeah, he has to finish the story. But I would have Cena in Cody's corner. But there may be some reason that's not going to happen. I don't know. Now they're talking about doing Rock and Roman Reigns versus Cody and Seth Rollins on night one's main event.
Honestly, Doink and Dink.
I'd like to see that. Speaking of Lawler, I'd like to see Lawler make an appearance. He had a stroke last year. And there was a story in the Memphis News that I saw recently. He's made a pretty good recovery, but he's had to like relearn how to talk. He's one of the greatest talkers in the business. So if Lawler was able to make it, that'd be cool too. But yeah, Cody has to go over, Patrick. Like, there's just no. If he doesn't go over,
can't compare to WrestleMania from Caesar's Palace where
Trump.
What happened? Yokozuna's manager.
Yes, Mr. Fuji.
Mr. Fuji, right, threw the salt in Bret Hart's eyes, and then Hogan jumped in and won it for the good guys.
That was one of the all-time greatest Hogan politicking maneuvers, too, by the way, to end up with the title there. WrestleMania 9. That was awesome. I remember watching that as a kid. That's one of my favorite WrestleManias just because of the visual. The Caesar's Palace visual. Jim Ross's debut was that night at WrestleMania as well, and they all had togas on.
So you agree with Vince Russo then about Hogan? You're
no, I'm a Hogan guy.
Battle of the Beach.
No, I'm a Hogan guy.
I hated Russo. He wasn't a wrestling guy.
Yeah, Russo completely ran WCW into the ground. I love WCW, by the way. I was NWO for life as well. And WCW is kind of the Southern wrestling representative, too. Of course, I love WWF as well. But
that was predictive programming, though. They called it New World Order, yeah, NWO.
Yeah, the NWO.
I was, whoa.
Is that Bobert? She's
looking good.
Wow. She's looking, nice. She's looking like scrumptious. Is she not? No. Wow.
No, we love and respect Lauren Bobert.
I would respect her very much. Yes, I could think of a few respectful things I would do. Damn. She was decked out there. Holy smokes.
She looks good in blue.
She does. She does look good in blue. I wasn't. I guess I should have expected
not
that.
Jill Biden.
No,
not
don't show her. Go back to Bobert. Green. What the fuck?
Yeah, some Bobert.
She was sitting by herself, too. Wow.
Not Marjorie hulking around.
Lumbering Marjorie around like Cornelius herself. From the Planet of the Apes. Yeah.
If she recalls Johnson, you know, I'll let the sleeping dogs lie, but I want Johnson recalled. I want more chaos, you know. I don't think Marjorie's going to do it, though. Hopefully Eli Crane will step up, or Gates. Somebody's got to stand up to Mike Johnson, man, and give us our fun again, you know, the chaos.
Well, he only has, what is the majority, like 4 votes or some shit like that? I don't know. It's not much. I'd have to double check on that. But
that devious little fellow told Hannity that he wants to get rid of the motion to vacate.
Yes.
He's the establishment's guy, dude.
Yes, and that's the only reason he's speaker in the first place. He wants to pull up the drawbridge behind him. I remember hearing that, yeah. Where the fuck is Biden? It's 9:17. What is this, dude? Are you serious? I don't think even Clinton kept us waiting this long. What in the fuck is going on? There he is.
Is over? Are they just telling us he's giving up?
Yeah, right. Is he just going to cancel this speech? It's 9:17. Fuck. I knew it would be a little late. They're always a little late, but fuck. It's coming up on the bottom of the hour. All right, here comes Biden. He's looking... Oof. Oh, is his daughter? Is he going to French kiss his daughter on the way down to the fucking podium? I guess he just got out of the shower with Ashley. He had to, you know. Oh, no. Why does nobody talk about that, by the way?
Total W for me, by the way. Still the exclusive home of the Ashley Biden Diary National Files. So.
That was your scoop, yeah.
Well, yeah, obviously too bad that they railroaded, you know, two people who were not guilty. But, you know, that's not good, of course. But the truth is out there, man. So,
but they never talk about that. Even elected Republicans, like I would be talking.
Who's they? We have to talk about it.
I know we have to, but you know,
we're not the media. Then QAnon says they're the news now, and that's not good.
That's not good.
Those pockets. Here are what the white hats are doing today. To protect your Social Security and Medicare savings.
Dude, they're still going strong, actually.
Oh, they are. They are.
You know where to look. They're still going really strong. Trust the plan. Trust the plan. Now here comes Biden. God, just let him get down there. They all got to get their handshake in.
He's going to make it. He's flanked by Schumer. Oh, my. They're going to have to carry him down. He's giving up.
This is just... It's going to take another fucking 20 minutes for him to get to the podium. Just at his normal walking speed, much less stopping and talking to all these people. What in the fuck? Did you hear Joe Scarborough? Did you hear Joe Scarborough? I think it was yesterday or day before. He said Biden was the sharpest he's ever been. The sharpest and the best he's ever been.
Sharp like the edge of that desk that Christopher Smith hit her head on.
A Holy Anderson sent $25 citizens of America to State of the Union is open. Now watch me take a fat rip off this cookie.
I want justice for Lori Clucidis at someday. We got to find out what happened there.
Oh, yeah, we talked about it. You know, some people didn't know that story about the poor intern who just happened to fall and hit her head right on the corner of the desk. Just imagine just the luck of that happening.
You know, back in the day when I was in D.C. at the Daily Caller, Joe Scarborough and Mika, that was like the peak of them being, you know, like D.C. relevant before Trump just like, you know, turned heel and just like ruined D.C. But in a good way, of course, like destroyed the
evil. He turned heel on them. It was the funniest thing ever. He
turned heel on them. And but back in the day, like the sharpest like critic of Joe and Mika, and they hated her, was the late Betsy Rothstein, my colleague at the Daily Caller, my date to the White House Correspondents' Dinner. Betsy Rothstein, rest in peace. She was one of them, but she was one of the few that I put in the – You know, I can put in the Hall of Fame. Her and I don't know, was Charles Schultz one of them? I don't know.
Yeah, I think
Ben Stein, maybe. Ben Stein, When Ben Stein's Money was a funny show.
Ben Stein was pretty good too, yeah.
Actually, Ray Goldenberg.
I like her a lot. I haven't talked to her in a while, but I used to hang out with her when I would go to D.C.
I was about to say Luma, but I don't know if I have to pay royalties to the Geffen estate or something, if I even, you know, or to the Loomer Unleashed branding enterprise, if I say that name on the
air. By the way, let me reread A-Hole Anderson's Super Chat here. He said, citizens of Buy America, the state of the... Junian is zogged. Now watch me take a fat rip off this pookie for 25. We're 40 off the goal. Can we hit the goal tonight? The speech hasn't even fucking started, and I'm not certain.
It's a better panel than CNN.
Yes, much better, I would have to say. And I appreciate you doing it because I was, you know, thinking of it's better to have somebody here to bounce off of with one of these speeches, and it's always a snooze fest, usually, unless it's Trump out there, you know, talking shit, right? Most of these.
Yeah, what's the latest with you? You seem like you're doing well. I've been, I've been writing a book. Campaign show is going to be back every day starting tomorrow morning. So from very now cool. until the election, every day, including weekends, I'm just going to, like, make a good video. So we got this big Biden voter fraud expose coming out tomorrow. Should be pretty good. And then I got to finish, you know, this book and, you know, hopefully make the literary history there too. Then I'll have, you know, website, show, made a movie
Tag called Seven Babies about CPS
kidnapping kids. And then book and, you know, just take over DC really. My buddy's going to run for delegate in Virginia next year. So I'm going to start my career as like a Dick Cheney, like Rasputin kind of advisor, you know.
That's right, the gray eminence there. Greece, whatever the French word is. I always just say
not Karl Rove or Ali Akbar. I don't time travel like Ali Akbar, so I'm not. Anytime I see old photos, I look at it to see if it's Ali from the 1920s. Like he morphed into it, like he's Jack Nicholson in The Shining at the Overlook Hotel, you know? Or I see a cat with three heads, and I'm like, what did Ali do in the Roaring 20s, you know? He made some blunder. It's like Quantum Leap. I don't know.
Imagine a Quantum Leap remake with Ali Akbar in the starring role.
He's in a flying carpet.
Who would be the guy? I forget Quantum Leap's partner. The guy is always talking to him and telling him not to fuck up history or whatever. Yeah. I don't know who his partner would be.
Leave history alone, Ali.
Oh.
Well, he managed to go back in time and not Diego get sent $5 charged, on I guess, Rumble. For January
5 weeks, I pooped my pants. Be right back.
A lot of people rotting away in the gulag over that. Tortured.
I wonder how he got out of that. You know, I've thought about that a few times.
But you know, my buddy Noel Fritsch, the publisher of National File, he always points out, so he was integrally involved in the 22 Days of Chaos and the motion to vacate against Kevin McCarthy. And so his next thing is Congress has authority over the jails in D.C. So if you're in the D.C. gulag in Washington, D.C., Congress can literally free those people. And Mike Johnson doesn't want to talk about it.
Yeah, there's a lot. And they still haven't released all the footage. Now, apparently they said they were going to release more soon. I don't know if that's happened or what. But
they could release everyone in the D.C. gulag. The Republican Congress could literally do that.
Yes.
So they're not.
Because they control the federal prisons. That's right. By the way, thank you. Yes, that's right. Thank you, Fio. Thank you, Cag Mike. What are we now? 30 away. If we hit it, I'm going to the Dino Museum. You asked me what was up with me. Well, I had a slippage there in January off my sober train and kind of, you know, had a fall and just been rebuilding the show back on sobriety over 3 weeks now and trying to do that the right way and work hard at the show and put on good shows. And you being here tonight.
Do they have Planet Fitness in Mexico?
They do. They have some gyms here. And I've dropped 100 pounds, but I haven't got, you know, like in shape like I want to. But I went from 280 to 177. So the last time you saw me, I think I was probably about 240, something like that.
You know, my latest gym is a library books. Keith and Ralph, now that I'm old, I want to learn. Like, I want to read. You know, as a kid in school, I was like, I don't want to do homework. Because, you know, the teachers are so awful, and they'd, you know, give us homework at night. But now, like, I actually want to, like, know stuff. Because I feel like I'm on the back nine here, and I'm middle-aged.
Yeah, you know, I've started to realize that I may have lived more years than I have left. That's kind of a heavy one, actually. I was thinking about that the other day. Joe Biden taunting me. That was a hilarious audio drop, by the way. Saying we can't hit the goal before the speech starts. Well, we're damn close. We did.
Good explosion sent $20 on Rumble.
Well, I'll be. Do it, let's go. Damn. We're gonna do the Dino Museum stream. And we did hit the goal before the speech starts. Holy shit. And in no small part to Patrick Howley here. Just a great, so much history. Legendary reporter above all. But just a fucking hilarious guy as well. And I'm glad to have you here. It looks like Biden might be about to start. So I guess I'll turn it up a little bit. And I will play that audio drop that Joe Biden sent in. I'm sorry I had to cut it. All right, here he is. I'll turn it down a little so we can still be heard over it.
Madam Vice President, members of Congress, my fellow Americans.
Yeah.
In January 1941, Franklin Roosevelt came to this chamber to speak to the nation. And he said, I address you at a moment unprecedented in the history of the Union. Hitler was on the march. War was raging in Europe. President Roosevelt's purpose was to wake up Congress and alert the American people that this was no ordinary time. Freedom and democracy were under assault in the world. Tonight, I come to this same chamber to address the nation. Now, it's we who face an unprecedented moment in the history of the Union. And yes, my purpose tonight is to wake up the Congress and alert the American people that this is no ordinary moment either. Not since President Lincoln and the Civil War have freedom and democracy been under assault at home as they are today. What makes our moment rare is that freedom and democracy are under attack at both at home and overseas at the very same time. Overseas, Putin of Russia.
We're a republic, not a democracy, first of all.
Ukraine, that's very true.
Sowing chaos throughout Europe and beyond. If anybody in this room thinks Putin will stop at Ukraine.
Dude, I'm so sick of this Ukraine bullshit. $280 billion to Ukraine. Just think of what that could have done for U.S. citizens.
Johnson's agreeing. He's vibing to it.
At least he didn't stand up, but we know where he really lies.
If we stand with Ukraine and provide the weapons that it needs to defend itself.
No. Hakeem Jeffries there. The minority leader in the House, literally.
That is all Ukraine is asking. They're not asking for American soldiers. In fact, there are no American soldiers at war in Ukraine, and I'm determined to keep it that way. But now,
I don't think so.
Assistance to Ukraine is being blocked by those who want to walk away from our world leadership. It wasn't long ago when a Republican president named Ronald Reagan thundered, Mr. Gorbachev.
So that's not true. By the way, the Florida National Guard trained the Ukrainian freaking military.
Wow. Not to mention all the CIA involvement over there and everything else. That's just.
Now my predecessor.
At least Sith Lord Newland resigned the other day.
Quote, do whatever the hell you want. That's a quote.
Based.
A former president actually said that, bowing down to a Russian leader, I think it's outrageous. It's dangerous and it's unacceptable. America is a founding member of NATO, the military alliance of democratic nations created after World War II to prevent war and keep the peace. And today, We've made NATO
stronger. Biden has no idea what's in NATO.
Welcome.
NATO. Israel, Taiwan, and Ukraine are not in NATO. So he has no clue what he's talking about.
Sweden officially joined, and their minister is here tonight. Stand up.
Their minister?
Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Want some chocolate?
How to fight.
Why didn't he bring some Swedish babes with him?
Mr. Prime Minister, welcome to
I guess they're too busy getting culturally enriched.
The world has ever seen. I say this to Congress. We have to stand up to Putin. Send me a bipartisan national security bill. History is literally watching. History is watching. If the United States walks away, it will put Ukraine at risk. Europe is at risk. The free world will be at risk, emboldening others to do what they wish to do us harm. My message to President Putin, who I've known for a long time, is simple. We will not walk away.
That's a big line. We will not walk away. He can barely walk. Mr. Putin, we will not amble. No. We will not saunter.
He will very slowly shuffle away.
We will not stroll lightly.
History is watching. Just like history watched 3 years ago on January 6th.
Oh, God.
When insurrectionists stormed this very
What about Charlottesville?
The throat of American
Do we think
democracy.
He'll bring that up?
Many of you are here on that darkest of days. We all saw with our own eyes the insurrectionists were not patriots. They'd come to stop the peaceful transfer of power, to overturn the will of the people. January 6th lies about the 2020 election and the plots to steal the election posed a great, gravest threat to U.S. democracy
what?
Since the Civil War.
Great,
but
gravest?
They failed. America stood.
They held the doors open for him, Joe.
Totally forgotten, dude.
America stood strong. And democracy prevailed. We must be honest. The threat to democracy must be defended. My predecessor and some of you here seek to bury the truth about January 6th. I will not do that. This is the moment to speak the truth and to bury the lies. Here's the simple truth. You can't love your country only when you win.
I really wish my dad never could stay around to weigh in on the Biden years.
As I've done ever since being elected to office, I ask all of you without regard to party to join together and defend democracy.
Yeah.
Remember your oath of office is defending against all threats, foreign and domestic. Respect. Respect free and fair elections. Restore trust in our institutions. And make clear political violence has absolutely no place, no place in America, zero place. Again, it's not hyperbole to suggest history is watching.
Kamala looks like she's had some kind of facelift,
your
by the way. I don't know. I'm just imagining that, but or Botox overload.
Another assault on freedom. Join us tonight is Latoya Beasley.
Who?
Social worker from Birmingham, Alabama.
Oh, they always
14 months ago, 14 months ago, she and her husband welcomed a baby girl thanks to the miracle of IVF.
Oh, yeah.
She scheduled treatments to have that second child. But the Alabama Supreme Court shut down IVF treatments across the state, unleashed by a Supreme Court decision overturning Roe v. Wade.
Didn't they pass a bill to reinstate IVF, though, already?
What her family got through should never have happened. Unless Congress acts, it could happen again. So tonight, let's stand up for families like hers. To my friends across the aisle, don't keep this waiting any longer. Guarantee the
Let's stand for the witches who want to sacrifice little babies. Let's stand for my friends in the satanic dungeons at the pizza parlors who just want to summon some demon energy from a lower dimension.
What do we think Hunter's doing right now,
like
by the way?
Americans, I believe Roe v. Wade got it right.
About 3 8 balls.
Thank President Harris for being an incredible leader defending reproductive freedom. And so much more.
I like how when they called him out recently, he was like, hey, you know, I never did this as a businessman, and certainly I would never do this as an artist. He is literally Joe Bluth. He's Joe Bluth from Arrested Development.
Join us tonight is Kate Cox.
It's an illusion.
Wife and mother from Dallas. She's become pregnant again and had a fetus of a fatal condition. Her doctor told Kate that her own life and her ability to have children of children in the future were at risk if she didn't act. Because Texas law banned her ability to act.
She's become pregnant again just from me looking at her.
What her family got.
By the way, hit like on the stream.
But it's happening to too many others.
And thank you for us hitting the goal. Round of applause.
Oh, you got Arnold's wife there. Are they still together after he knocked up the...
No.
They got divorced. No, they're not. Many of you in this chamber. He's a Kennedy, though. They're on the upswing.
Yeah.
To pass a national ban on
by the way, how was that a secret? The kid looked just like him. Like, have you seen him? Like,
you literally have kindergarten cop in kindergarten. Who could have fathered this child?
With all due respect,
no idea who sired this.
It was like a Mexican cleaning lady, too. And the kid looks just like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I'm about to realize just how much you were right about that.
Arnold getting done after a workout, and, you know.
She was not a prize either. She wasn't a hot mamacita. She wasn't muy caliente.
But, you know, she was there.
That's right. She was there.
She was like Wally. She wasn't like Wally Pipp. She was like Lou Gehrig. She didn't miss the game.
They have no clue about the
Iron Horse.
But they found out. When reproductive freedom was on the ballot, we won in 2022 and 2020, and we'll win again in 2024. If you, the American people...
AOC's wearing all black, by the way, not white.
...the right to choose, I promise you, I'll restore Roe v. Wade as the law
the
of the land.
The power of women, he says. I know about the power of women.
This is the creepiest thing I've ever seen. Folks.
I know a little something about it, too. I'd rather not speak on it, though.
Right. I'm here tonight to show what I believe is
space
the way forward.
Space world, girl power.
This is
summoning back to the Space Girls era.
4 years ago, next week, before I came to office, the country was hit by the worst pandemic and the worst
economic
crisis in a century. Remember the fear?
I remember
losses.
All that bullshit, yeah.
Remember the spikes in crime and the murder rate, raging virus.
I remember not being able to see my mother when she fucking died because of motherfuckers like you.
Loved ones, millions left behind. A mental health crisis of isolation and loneliness. A president, my predecessor, failed the most basic presidential duty that he owes to American people, the duty to care. I think that's unforgivable. I came to office determined to get us through one of the toughest periods in the nation's history. We have. It doesn't make news, but news in 1,000 cities and towns, the American people are writing the greatest comeback story never told.
I can't think of a story never told, and it has nothing to do with this!
So let's tell the story here.
Fucker.
He's like the Dana Carvey character, the cranky old man. Yeah. I'm a cranky old man.
Possibilities. Building an economy.
Don't you love how a lot of these old folks call themselves senior citizens?
I'm all Americans. In all Americans.
It's like, really, you've graduated to the level of selling your house to BlackRock now?
No one behind.
It's your seniority.
The pandemic no longer controls our lives.
Just old fucks, I think, settles it a little bit better.
Are now being used to beat cancer, turning setback into comeback. That's what America does. That's what America does. Folks, my inherited economy is on the brink. Now our economy is literally the envy of the world.
That's not true.
15 million new jobs in just 3 years. A record. A record. Unemployment at 50-year lows.
And the dollar's crashing out against the peso, you fuck. Don't get me started.
16 million Americans are starting small businesses, and each one is a literal act of hope. With historic job growth and small business growth for Black and Hispanics, and
I think this
Americans,
is a big mistake to run on how great the economy is.
Jobs in America and
literally country. Nobody feels that way.
Where is it written we can't be the
There's that fucking
the world.
Goblin,
are,
Janet Yellen.
The Penguin, man. The Penguin. From Batman Returns, the best. Tim Burton, you agree, the second Tim Burton.
It was so
Michael
good.
Keaton
was
the best.
Was the Penguin line?
Yeah, Danny DeVito is the Penguin. He lived underneath the streets of Gotham. He actually ran for mayor, and then Batman had to expose him for being crooked. I was picking up on that when I was a little kid. I was like,
he lived underneath Gotham in the tunnels.
Being like, ha ha, the people in Gotham, they don't know, but they're really evil. And he played it from the loudspeaker at the campaign rally. And that was like my first taste of politics. I was like, man.
Yeah. Consumer studies show consumer confidence is soaring.
He literally did live underneath Gotham.
Lived underneath Gotham with this Penguin army. Kind of like a similar group in New York City, but there have been tunneling underneath the city. On my watch, federal projects that you find. Shabbat Lubavitch. Perhaps Jared Kushner knows a thing or two about Shabbat Lubavitch. Made with American products and built by American workers.
Creating good paying American jobs. And thanks to our CHIPS and Science Act, the United States is investing more in research and development than ever before. During the pandemic, a shortage of semiconductors, chips, that drove up the price of everything from cell phones to automobiles.
Chips, yeah, we got it.
By the way, we invented those chips right here in America.
And then we let the Chinese steal them.
Private companies are now investing billions of dollars to build new chip factories here in America.
Has he talked about shrinkflation yet?
No, I don't think.
That's a serious concern, though. As a populist, I called that BS out a few years ago, actually.
Shrinkflation.
There's almost no chips in a bag. You get a bag of chips. You might as well go to the Attorney General and file a complaint. It's like 20% filled. Okay.
It's gotten way worse even since the 90s. Like, oh my God. Literally, like 60% of the bag is air.
Yeah, no, it is.
And thanks to our bipartisan infrastructure law, 46,000
much like Biden himself,
all across your communities. And by the way, I noticed some of you strongly voted against.
Oh, Pete Buttigieg sitting uncomfortably.
Wow, what is he sitting on? Is he sitting on his husband's lap? But what was that? That was a weird.
If you don't want that money in your district, just let me know. Modernizing our roads and bridges, ports and airports, public transit systems. Removing poisonous lead pipes so every child can drink clean water without risk of brain damage. Providing affordable.
I wonder if Kamala is going to try to raise the roof at some point. Connect with her urban soul.
Communities. She do one of these.
Record investments in tribal communities. Because of my investment in a family farm.
Charity wears the Converse because she's a black person from 1962.
She's going to dab on him.
She's Wilt Chamberlain.
We're better able had to sex with the same amount of people, too.
Oh, the setup punchline there. Fantastic. Laurel and Hardy, yes.
Home to an auto plant for nearly 60 years. Before I came to office.
Where's Willie Brown? That's what I want to know.
Willie treated her better than Biden.
For sure.
Willie treated her right.
Then I was elected to office and we raised the Belvedere.
Now, Roger Stone always talks about how Kamala was like a one woman get out the vote operation, you know, for the lawmakers in California.
Instead of auto factories shutting down, real grassroots activists, yeah. To power
those cars. Well, look where she is. Look at where we're sitting, okay?
It's true, I mean.
Vice president there, towed her way to the top. That's a tough hoe.
You suck enough dick, you go straight to the top. That's just how it works.
You need Gina Gershon from Showgirls to be, you know, to give her a speech about being a tough hoe, making it in this town. Can you imagine if Nikki Haley had run against Kamala in a hoe versus hoe hoedown?
With higher wages, are building the future in Belvedere right here in America.
Okay, Joe.
Here tonight,
is UAW President Sean Fain, a great friend and a great labor leader. Sean, where are you? Stand up.
Oh, yeah, that was a great strike you guys did.
And Dawn.
Ford said they weren't going to build any more plants in America. That was a great Dawn idea. Jim.
I think Hakeem Jeffries is possessed by Satan.
Worker, UAW worker at Belvedere.
He looks like a Tales from the Hood or some shit. You ever seen that? Yeah.
A good job in her hometown, providing stability for her family.
Like the look he's got.
Pride and dignity as well. Showing once again, Wall Street didn't build America. They're not bad guys. They didn't build it, though. The middle class built the country.
Now, Wall Street are bad guys. No, wrong.
Oh, God. I say to the American people,
Schumer rubbing his hand.
When America gets knocked down, we get back up.
Schumer's just a sieving to the people.
That's America.
I'm just sieving all the folks in the villages. It was a tough choice. They were going to vote for Laura Luma, but they decided to vote for the vaccine so that their families could be injected with mRNA injections, turn them into human experiments.
Imagine if Luma was in this crowd right now.
Now, APAC would be, I don't think they would mind that too much.
No, they wouldn't.
So I want to be like this. So I told you my buddy's running for a delegate in Virginia. He's going to be the Matt Gaetz of Virginia and then, go for governor.
That'd be sick.
That we can build together.
Yeah, that'd be pretty awesome.
A future where the days of trickle-down economics are over and the wealthy and the biggest...
He's not good, but he's term-limited, so it's going to be something
true.
New.
Yeah, it's always term-limited in
corporations. I come from a state that has more corporations invested than every one of your states in the state of the United States combined. And I represented it for 36 years. I'm not anti-corporation.
No shit. Delaware is the most corrupt state.
In a home where trickle-down economics didn't put much on my dad's kitchen table.
Oh, God.
That's why I determined to turn things around so middle class does well.
Trickle-down economics?
When they do well, the poor are way up in the wealthy.
You were already in Congress when they started that, Joe. What are you talking about?
And there's more to do to make sure you're feeling the benefits of all we're doing. America.
I never believed in trickle-down economics.
Me either.
It's wrong.
It's more like
your head and tell them that it's raining, but I...
Pitching down economics, yeah.
But that didn't start. Joe was already in Congress when... Okay, whatever.
For the law that I proposed and signed, not one of you Republican buddies voted for it. We finally beat Big Pharma.
Instead of
paying $400 a month or thereabouts for insulin with diabetes, and it only costs $10 to make, they only get paid $35 a month now and still make a healthy profit. And I want to... But what to do next? I want to cap the cost of insulin at $35 a month for every American.
Insulin is like... Everyone. I don't have to take it, to be clear, before the A-log start. But it's like $3 in Mexico or some shit that.
People have talked about it, but finally we got it done. Gave Medicare the power to negotiate lower prices
on prescription drugs. When America gets knocked down, it gets back up for another shot of fentanyl from China routed through Mexico.
Don't you think the president of Mexico should be playing up that all the cancer cures are there because the FDA ran them to Mexico?
He should, absolutely.
Why is Bernie wearing a mask? Are you kidding me?
Because Medicare...
Is he the only one in the whole place with a mask on?
Those exorbitant prices to Big Pharma. This year, Medicare is negotiating lower prices for some of the costliest drugs on the market that treat everything from heart disease to arthritis. It's now time to go further and give Medicare the power to negotiate lower prices for 500 different drugs over the next decade. They're making a lot of money, guys. And they'll still be extremely profitable. They'll not only save lives, it will save taxpayers another $200 billion. Starting next year, the same law caps total prescription drug costs for seniors on Medicare at $2,000.
It's time Kamala stands up. Do you think she's going to start riding a bull?
$10,000,
$12,000,
$15,000.
Do one of these right here.
I want to cap prescription drug costs at $2,000 a year for everyone.
This is a highly partisan speech, even for a State of the Union. Of course, it's election year, but
Not very unifying.
Thank you. We'll come again was Kamala's slogan with the gentleman. Even Moscow, probably. I actually did honestly hear that her nickname at the U.S. Capitol is Stinky Pirate Hooker. 40% the cost you're paying.
Same company, same drug. Nobody likes Kamala. Place.
Folks, the Affordable Care Act, the old Obamacare, is still a very big deal.
It's a very bad deal. Don't get me started. Is Biden on coke? I don't know. Maybe Hunter let him dip into the stash before he came out.
Denied health insurance because of pre-existing condition.
My chat asked that.
Well, my predecessor and many in this chamber want to take this prescription drug away by repealing the Affordable Care Act. I'm not going to let that happen. We stopped you 50 times before and we'll stop you again.
Beat some Bo Bear. Pretty.
Yeah, can we get another shot of her?
I'm protecting and I'm expanding it. They enact the tax credits of $800 per person per year.
Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, so Beetlejuice.
Millions of working families. That tax credit expires next year. I want to make that savings.
That permanent. Was a nice one. She was looking lovely. Can we see her again, please, cameraman?
Women
what is going on?
Our population, but research on women's health has always been underfunded. That's why we're launching the first ever White House initiative on women's health research.
That's exactly what we need.
Led by Jill, doing an incredible job as first lady.
My son Hunter is having difficulty even affording the drugs that he needs.
He told me Plan B prices are through the roof.
Do you even know what it costs the average American to pay off a hooker nowadays? And they're angrier than ever, those gals.
I know the cost of housing is so important to you. If inflation keeps coming down, mortgage rates will come down as well. And the Fed acknowledges that. But I'm not waiting. I want to provide an annual tax credit that will give Americans $400 a month for the next 2 years as mortgage rates come down to put toward their mortgages when they buy their first home. Or trade up for a little more space. Just for 2 years. And my administration is also eliminating title insurance on federally backed mortgages. When you refinance your home, you can save $1,000 or more.
I see some drama between Rashida and Joe over Palestine.
Yeah, me too.
Big landlords.
She's the one who led that uncommitted campaign in Michigan. Was highly successful, by the way.
Doing more for me than Mike Johnson.
We've cut red tape so builders can get federally financing, which is already helping build.
There's something to Rashida. Would you agree? I mean, there's a little. I mean, AOC looks like a seven, but she is not that far behind, you know. She gets going about Israel. It's like
sure. It's kind of hot. Renovate 2 million. She got a nice pair too, actually.
Bring those rents down. To remain the strongest economy in the world, we need to have the best education system in the world.
And you're right, Edelwolf.
And I suspect all of you, want to give a child, every child, a good start.
Yeah.
By providing access to preschool for 3 and 4 years old. You know, I think I pointed out last year.
There's a guy who sued me, Mark Kelly. I defeated him.
That's right. I forgot about that.
I think I pointed out last year that children coming from broken homes where there's no books, they're not read to, not spoken to very often, start school, kindergarten, or first grade, having heard a million fewer words spoken. Well, studies show that children who go to preschool are nearly 50% more likely to finish high school, go on to earn a 2- and 4-year degree, no matter what their background is. I met a year and a half ago with the leaders of the business roundtable. They were mad that they were angry. I think, well, they were discussing why I wanted to spend money on education. I pointed out to them, as vice president, I met with over eight, I think it was 182 of those folks. Don't hold me the exact number. And I asked them what they need most, the CEOs. And you've had the same experience on both sides of the aisle. They say a better educated workforce, right? So I looked at them and I say, I come from Delaware. DuPont used to be the eighth largest corporation in the world. And every new enterprise they bought, they educated the workforce to that enterprise. But none of you do that anymore. Why are you angry with me providing you the opportunity for the best educated workforce in the world?
He does that a lot. It's perfect. Right. He thinks it's
badass.
It's just strange.
Summer learning.
I'll take another scoop of ice cream. He thinks he's John Wayne or something. I don't know.
Yeah, it's just really weird.
I'm also connecting. Can you imagine what Ashley thinks when she hears that whisper?
So students get hands-on.
She's heard it many times before, I'm sure.
Paying job, whether or not they go to college. And I want to make sure the college
You're
is
looking
more
all
affordable.
Dirty there, Ashley. We need to hop in the shower.
Let's continue.
Imagine ruining the shower for someone, you know, like my favorite place.
Right, for their whole life.
A minority serving institution, including Hispanic institutions.
Schumer probably knows something about that.
And I was told I couldn't universally just change the way in which we dealt with student loans.
What would Madison Cawthorn have done if he had become vice president?
Reduce the burden of student debt for nearly
something badass, I'm sure.
Americans, including nurses.
He couldn't do the standing up, though. I'm always much better at the standing up.
Like Billy Ray Valentine from Tiny Places.
Ben, thank you. He's educated hundreds of students so they can go to college. Now he's able to help, after debt forgiveness, get his own daughter to college.
Why is he yelling?
Yeah, he goes from whisper to yell all the time. Who is that? Some NBA player? What a...
Such relief is
that guy play for the Houston Rockets?
Why? Folks are now able to buy a home, start a business, start a family. While we're at it, I want the public school teachers a raise.
Yeah, that's what they deserve. The great public school teachers of America.
Every day there's more genders to teach. We cut the deficit. And more funding for all of them.
Now let me speak to the question of fundamental fairness for all Americans.
I myself, Joe Biden, am pansexual.
We've already cut the federal
I have just learned this today.
I signed the bipartisan deal to cut another $1 trillion in the next decade. It's my goal to cut the federal deficit another $3 trillion by making big corporations, the very wealthy, finally beginning to pay their fair share.
Oh, there she is in black. Looking pretty sinister.
She is.
Not looking bad, though.
No, she wasn't looking bad, no. Great.
Just pay your fair share in taxes. A fair tax code is how we invest things to make this country great. Healthcare, education, defense, and so much more. But here's the deal. The last administration enacted a $2 trillion tax cut. Overwhelmingly benefit the top 1%, the very wealthy and the biggest corporation. And exploded the federal deficit. They added more to the national debt than any presidential term in American history. Check the numbers. Folks at home, does anybody really think the tax code is fair?
Boo, you suck.
Do you really think the wealthy and big corporations need another $2 trillion tax break? No! I sure don't. I'm going to keep fighting like hell to make it fair. Under my plan, nobody earning less than $400,000 a year will pay additional pennies.
Imagine Joe Biden reading to kids like Bush on
9/11. It's like my pet goat, thing. Yeah.
And then you find out 9/11 just happened and Biden there is still like leering at you. What is going on?
During the pandemic, cut taxes for millions of working families and cut child poverty in half. Restore that child tax credit. No child should go hungry in this country.
Then why are we sending all of our money to Ukraine and Israel?
It's to make big corporations, the very wealthy, begin to pay their fair share. Remember in 2020, 55 of the biggest companies in America made $40 billion and paid zero in federal income tax. Zero. Not anymore.
Yeah, this is what you're talking about before
we signed. Big companies have to pay a minimum of 15%.
Yeah.
But that's still less.
Is it going to be 110 countries or not?
It's time to raise corporate minimum tax to at least 21%. So every big corporation
is that one Republican standing up over
begins to pay their fair share. Also want to end tax breaks for big pharma, big oil, private jets, massive executive pay when it's only supposed to be $1 million it could be deducted.
Slow down, Joe.
They can pay them $20 million if they want, but deduct $1 million. End it now. You know, there are 1,000 billionaires in America. You know what the average federal tax is for those billionaires? No. They're making great sacrifices, 8.2%. That's far less than the vast majority of Americans pay. No billionaire should pay a lower federal tax rate than a teacher, a sanitation worker, or a nurse.
This speech sucks.
I propose.
Were you expecting it to be good?
No, but
25%.
Who was that raising his pimp stick in the crowd? Did you see that? What the fuck was that?
$500 billion.
Looked like a lily stick.
Imagine what that could do for America. Imagine a future with affordable child care. Millions of families can get they need to go to work to help grow the economy. Imagine a future with paid leave, because no one should have to choose between working and taking care of their sick family member. Imagine.
Oh, they're vibing to this.
Imagine the future of home care and elder care and people living with disabilities so they can stay in their homes and family care and finally get the pay they deserve. Tonight,
they
let's
just
all
want
agree
an old white guy to tell them what to do.
Stand up for seniors. Many of my friends.
You're 81 years
on
old.
The other side of aisle want to put Social Security on the chopping block. If anyone here tries to cut Social Security,
is that Marge?
Is that Marge? That's what it must be. It looked like her.
Had the hat on. Kind of disrespectful if you ask me to wear a hat in the State of the Union. But then again, you're disrespecting Biden, you know, so whatever.
Pay
allow
more
it.
Into Social Security than millionaires and billionaires do. It's not fair. We have two ways to go. Republicans can cut Social Security and give more tax breaks to the wealthy. I will. That's the proposal.
She was not looking as good as Blueberry Bobert, though.
Not at all.
I kind of thought that's what your plan was. Well, that's good to hear.
Chad just said, what did he just say? No billionaire should pay more than the working class. Yeah, he flubbed that.
That's good to hear. I'll protect and strengthen Social Security and make the wealthy pay their fair share.
Somehow, mysteriously, that doesn't ever happen.
A doll wolf sent $1.
Oh, wow. Creator of Dragon Ball pronounced dead.
Dragon Ball, Akira Toriyama, was just pronounced dead. Subdermal hematoma.
Wow.
He was 68. All of his projects are now frozen.
Press
RIP.
From food to healthcare to housing. In fact, the snack companies think you won't notice if they change the size of the bag and put a hell of a lot fewer.
Well, what do you think about this, Jake? Put fewer chips in. Freaking
he's
Tyson
talking about
fight.
The chips. Oh, I hope Tyson just knocks his head pass off, but Bobby Casey's bill and stop probably won't
this.
Happen.
I really mean it.
Probably a gentleman's agreement for Jake Paul to win by decision somehow or something like that. He's talking about the chips, the actual chips this time.
All saw that
potato.
Snickers bars.
Yeah?
You get to charge the same amount, and you got about, I don't know, 10% fewer Snickers in it. Look.
There's one single
I'm
Snickers,
getting
whatever.
Rid of junk fees. Those hidden fees at the end of your bill that are there without your knowledge. My administration announced we're cutting credit card late fees from $32 to $8.
Shit, so said someone get the Dragon Ball, we can bring him back. All right, it's too soon.
Allowed to charge what it costs them to instigate the collection. And that's more, a hell of a lot, like $8 and 30-some dollars. They don't like it. Credit card companies don't like it. But I'm saving American families $20 billion a year with all the junk fees I'm eliminating. Folks at home, that's why the banks are so mad, is $20 billion in profit. I'm not stopping there. My administration proposed rules to make cable, travel, utilities.
Under my leadership, we're going to catch them all. Charizard, even you in the cave. You only get one chance at him. That's the story of America.
In November, my team began serious negotiations with a bipartisan group of senators. The result was a bipartisan bill with the toughest set of border security reforms we've ever seen. Oh, you don't think so?
Langford looks like he sacrifices dogs.
Oh, you don't like that bill, huh? That conservatives got together and said it was a good bill? I'll be darned. That's amazing. That bipartisan bill would hire 1,500 more security agents and officers, 100 more immigration judges to help tackle the backload of 2 million cases, 4,300 more asylum officers, and new policies so they can resolve cases in 6 months instead of 6 years now.
Langford agreeing.
What are you against? 100 more high-tech drug detection machines to significantly increase the ability to screen and stop vehicles smuggling fentanyl into America. That's killing thousands of children. This bill would save lives and bring order to the border. It would also give me and any new president new emergency authority.
Stop besmirching Mexico, Joe.
The number of migrants at the border is overwhelming.
You need to represent Mexico, Ralph. You need to be the delegate.
That's right.
No, look at the facts.
Work all these issues out.
I have to get more politically active.
We're doing diplomacy right now.
True. An international broadcast of the State of the Union.
I believe that given the opportunity for a majority in the House and Senate would endorse the bill as well. A majority right now. But unfortunately,
are you like a not my president Mexican? This you don't even think Joe's your. Well, I mean, Joe's obviously, he didn't get elected.
Members of Congress in the Senate.
Yeah, I'm in exile.
He feels political.
I'm just an observer to this now.
Be a political win for me and a political loser for him. It's not about him. It's not about me.
The great AMLO is my president.
Not really.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, is that Marjorie yelling?
Lincoln Riley, an innocent young woman who was killed by an illegal. That's right. But how many of thousands of people being killed by illegals? To her parents, I say, my heart goes out to you, having lost children myself. I understand. But look,
he
if
always
we change
does that.
The dynamic at the border.
Drama.
People pay these smugglers $8,000 to get across the border because they know if they get by, if they get by and let into the country, it's 6 to 8 years before they have a hearing. And it's worth it taking the chance of the $8,000. But
Biden, you issued a
if it's only
ton of executive
months,
orders
weeks,
gutting border security as soon as you came in. Whatever.
It's highly unlikely that people will pay that money and go.
No one believes you, Joe.
They'll be able to be kicked out quickly. Folks, I would respectfully suggest my Republican friends owe it to the American people.
Byron's not happy.
Done.
Byron Donalds is like Chef from South Park. he's the voice of reason.
Also, Biden is really losing steam here. More flubs per second as the speech goes on. The Adderall Adrenochrome, whatever mixture he has, is wearing off.
Politics and pressuring members of Congress to block the bill. Join me.
How much adrenochrome would even be necessary to keep him going through this whole thing?
But apparently, here's what he will not do.
We're talking like a whole Haitian village.
Saying they are poison in the blood of our country.
Well, there has been a lot of unrest in Haiti recently. Maybe those two things are connected. The stable Haitian government, as always. I can't believe that's happening down there.
Unlike my predecessor on my first day in office, I introduced a comprehensive bill to fix our immigration system. Take a look at
what?
It. As all
slow down.
More. Secure the border. Provide a pathway to citizenship for dreams.
Mayorkas looks so like a reptilian.
He does.
But unlike my predecessor.
You know, even with that Spanish sounding last name, Mayorkas actually is a member of the tribe.
That is true.
Draws from old and new.
Undercover.
Home to same with Yellen and Blinken.
Been here for thousands of years.
home, and the majority of his cabinet.
From every place on earth. Yeah.
They came freely. And the banks in Hollywood.
Some came when famine struck.
Anything else?
Family in Ireland.
Some the fleet. Anything worth a shit, they run it.
That are possible anywhere, but
they don't play it, though.
That's true.
That's America. And we all come from somewhere. But we're all American.
Except for Goldberg, who kicked Bret Hart in the head.
Ended his career with a mule kick.
Ticked off about that one.
Look, folks. We had a simple choice.
His original character, the Holodomor, didn't fly, so he's Goldberg.
I'm ready to fix it. Send me the border bill now.
I was always instinctively anti-Goldberg, and I wasn't. I don't know why. It was just.
Formational history.
He couldn't wrestle, man. It was like 30 seconds.
59 years ago today in Selma, Alabama.
Something sinister about him.
Even as a kid, I knew. Was something there. It was unnatural how he was being pushed, you know, undefeated streak. It was just not right.
Hey, guess who's super tough? Goldberg.
Our late friend and former colleague.
Not like Dr. Goldberg down the road.
So even tough. As a child, something didn't feel right. just being crammed down our throats. We didn't even want it. It's just like, you're going to love Goldberg. I was like, what the fuck? No.
Our other marchers, both in the gallery and on the floor, including Betty Mae Fikes, known as the voice of Selma, the daughter of gospel singers and preachers. She sang songs of prayer and protest on that bloody Sunday. To help shake the nation's conscience. 5 months later, the Voting Rights Act passed and was signed into law.
Again with the yelling.
Thank you.
How do we get so many shots of these ugly motherfuckers? Put Boebert back on the screen. We got one shot of her.
But 59 years later, their forces taking us back in time. Voter suppression, election subversion, unlimited dark money, extreme gerrymandering. John Lewis is a great friend to many of us here, but if you truly want to honor him,
you're going to join him soon, I'm pretty certain.
Then it's time to do more than talk. Pass the Freedom to Vote Act, the John Lewis Voting Rights Act.
You think they're going to say that Biden has COVID and then just, you know, like, take him off his
mysterious
poop or whatever? Yeah.
Core value of America.
You know, if there's like a Biden impersonator, I mean, could you imagine if he made like a power move like Dave?
I was just about to mention Dave. You made me think of that. It's such a great movie.
It's excellent.
Pass the Equality Act. My message to transgender Americans.
Oh, don't forget those. Well, you can have their back. I don't want to.
Pass the PRO Act for workers' rights. Raise the federal minimum wage because every worker has a right to a decent living more than $7 an hour. We're also making history by confronting the climate crisis, not denying it. I don't think any of you think there's no longer a climate crisis. At least I hope you don't.
What's the psychology of AOC having the pussified white boyfriend?
You saw that? Did you see her get ambushed the other day by Palestinian protesters and her cuck boyfriend was like, no, this is not right. Just stop.
I can't imagine he's locking that down.
No way.
80% of America's lands and waters by 2030. And taking action on environmental
not
justice,
a chica like
line
that.
Communities smothered by the legacy of pollution. In pattern after the Peace Corps and America Corps, I launched the Climate Corps to put 20,000 young
what an
people
original one.
In the forefront of our clean energy future. I'll triple
wow.
the number in a decade.
I didn't see that
Scooby coming. Scooby-Doo ice cream, you know me. Go, buddy.
To state the obvious, all Americans deserve the freedom to be safe. And America is safer today than when I took office. Year before I took office, murder rates were up 30%. 30%
what?
Went up. The biggest increase in history. It was then. Through no, through my American.
This guy's getting thrown out. What did he say, though? I couldn't quite make it out.
We made the largest investment in public safety ever. Last year, the murder rates saw the sharpest decrease in history.
I would totally yell and boo during this.
For sure.
Why not?
Lowest levels in more than 50 years. But we have more to do. We have to help cities invest in more community police.
He screamed so loud I couldn't quite hear what he was saying.
More community violence intervention.
United States something.
To crack down on gun crime, retail crime, and carjacking.
Something about Marines, somebody in chat said.
Trusters have been doing by taking executive action on police reform and calling for it to be the law of the land.
He knew he was about to get tossed. He was walking towards the exit.
Cabinet to review the federal classification of marijuana and expunging thousands of convictions for the mere possession, because no one should be jailed for simply using or having on their record.
Well, that's pretty funny coming from you, Joe.
Take on crimes of domestic violence.
If you know Suck, Joe Biden's bro. Record.
I'm up the federal enforcement of the Women Act that I proudly wrote when I was a senator. So we can finally end the scourge against women shit. In America.
I don't feel like he has my best interest.
There are other kinds of violence I want to stop. With us tonight is
Has he said
Jasmine.
Anything that's gotten the Republicans to stand up so far? I don't think so.
With 21 classmates and teachers in elementary school in Uvalde, Texas. Very soon after
this
that
may
happened,
be the
Joel
most highly partisan State of the Union I've ever seen.
We spent hours and hours with each of the families. We heard their message, so everyone in this room, in this chamber, could hear the same message. The constant refrain, and I was there for hours meeting with every family. They said, do something. Do something. Well, I did do something by establishing the first ever Office of Gun Violence Prevention in the White House, that the Vice President is leading the charge. Thank you for doing it.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I can't talk politics
Meanwhile,
with you. Because you
I don't think Johnson
me.
Stood up yet, Dad. Have you seen him?
Say what?
Have you seen Johnson
no,
stand up yet?
No, I haven't.
That's good, at
Meanwhile,
least.
My predecessor,
if he stands up, I'm going to give him some shit.
He's proud he did nothing on guns when he was president. Oh. After another shooting in Iowa recently, he said, when asked what to do about it, he said, just get over it. There's his quote. Just get over it. I say, stop it. Stop it, stop it, stop it. I'm proud we beat the NRA when I signed most significant gun safety law in nearly 30 years because of this Congress. We now must beat the NRA again. I'm demanding a ban on assault weapons and high-capacity magazines. Pass universal background checks. None of this.
That cane is really doing a lot of work there in
That's
the audience.
That's what I was saying, man. The pimp stick is going to work out tonight.
Violates the Second Amendment. Or vilifies responsible gun owners. You know, as we manage challenges at home, we're also managing crises abroad, including in the Middle East.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the last 5 months.
How's that management going?
For so many people, for the Israeli people, for the Palestinians, and so many here in America. This crisis began on October 7th with a massacre by a terrorist group called Hamas, as you all know. 1,200 innocent people. Women and girls, men and boys, slaughtered after enduring sexual violence.
Watch him stand up
the
for this.
The deadliest day for the Jewish people since the Holocaust.
Oh,
and
God.
250 hostages taken.
Oh, fuck.
I don't have a cigarette. Tonight, sorry. Our families whose loved ones are still being held by Hamas. I pledge to all the families that we will not rest until we bring every one of your loved ones home. We also...
Watch him stand up. Told you! Told you! Told you he would stand up for that.
Do it up. You called it.
I told you.
We'll also work around the clock to bring home Evan and Paul, Americans being unjustly detained by the Russians and others around the world. Israel has the right to go after Hamas. Hamas ended this conflict by releasing hostages, laying down arms, could end it.
Oh, standing Mike.
By releasing the hostages, laying down arms, and surrendering those responsible for October 7th. But Israel has a excuse me, Israel has a added burden. because Hamas hides and operates among the civilian population like cowards, under hospitals, daycare centers, and all the like. Israel also has a fundamental responsibility, though, to protect innocent civilians in Gaza. This war has taken a greater toll on innocent civilians.
The Republicans sit for that.
Wars in Gaza combined. More than 30,000 Palestinians have been killed, most of whom are not Hamas.
Says who? Some
thousands
fucking
and
idiot.
Thousands of innocents, women and children, girls and boys, also orphaned. Nearly 2 million more Palestinians under bombardment or displacement. Homes destroyed, neighbors in rubble, cities in ruin, families without food, water, medicine. It's heartbreaking. I've been working nonstop to establish an immediate ceasefire that would last for 6 weeks to get all the prisoners released, all the hostages released, to get the hostages home and ease the intolerable and humanitarian crisis and build toward an enduring, something more enduring. The United States has been leading in
nice. There you go, Rashida.
Yeah, base.
Tonight, I'm directing the U.S. military to lead an emergency mission to establish a temporary pier in the Mediterranean on the coast of Gaza that can receive large shipments carrying food, water, medicine, and temporary shelters. No U.S. boots will be on the ground. A temporary pier will enable a massive increase in the amount of humanitarian assistance getting into Gaza every day.
And Republicans sit for that.
Must do its part.
Not that it's a great plan, by the way, but whatever.
Israel must allow more aid into Gaza to ensure humanitarian workers aren't caught in the crossfire. And they're announcing they're going to have a crossing in northern Gaza. For the leadership of Israel, I say this. Humanitarian assistance cannot be a secondary consideration or a bargaining chip. Protecting and saving innocent lives has to be a priority. As we look to the future,
base.
The only real solution to the situation.
Stop sending bombs is what the other side of that said.
And I say this as a lifelong supporter of Israel. My entire career, no one has a stronger record with Israel than I do. I challenge any of you here. I'm the only American president to visit Israel in wartime. But there is no other path that guarantees Israel's security and democracy. There is no other path that guarantees Palestinian can live in peace with peace and dignity. And there's no other path that guarantees peace between Israel and all of its neighbors, including Saudi Arabia, with whom I'm talking.
We've already killed so many of these Palestinians at this point that they're just like.
That's why I build a coalition.
And they're already like tons of these kids in the graves.
Defend international shipping.
And their whole fucking
the Red Sea.
Shit is wiped out, too.
Strikes to degrade the Houthi capability and defend U.S. forces in the region. As commander in chief,
the Houthis ain't going
to direct further measures to protect our people and our military personnel.
He's starting to slur. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. As the speech goes longer,
for years,
it's noticeable, very noticeable.
Many of my Republican and Democratic friends say that China is on the rise.
Why would I
America's
say that?
Falling behind.
That's sounds like Pelosi back. After a few shooters.
When I wasn't president.
A few mimosas with the gal. She just becomes like the old mom on Arrested Development. I'll tell you when I've had enough.
And we're standing up against China's unfair economic practices.
Is that Swalwell who was banging a Chinese spy?
I revitalized our partnership and alliance in the Pacific.
India, think about how cool he Australia, thought he was when he
Japan,
started dating that Chinese
South
chick.
Korea, Pacific Islands.
Meanwhile, sure she's wearing like a long trench American coat, and there are like two other voices coming from underneath it. Say that again, white man.
Well, it's tough talk on China.
Well, I didn't quite catch that, leaning in with her shoulder. Like,
I want competition with China, not conflict. And we're in a stronger position to win the conflict of the 21st century against China than anyone else, for that matter, than any time as well. Here at home.
No, we're not.
I've signed over 400 bipartisan bills. But there's more to pass my unity agenda. Strengthen penalties on fentanyl trafficking. You don't want to do that, huh? pass bipartisan privacy legislation to protect our children online. Harness.
I'm sure that's what it's all about.
AI to protect us from peril. Ban AI voice impersonations and more.
What?
And keep our truly sacred obligation to train and equip those we send into harm's way and care for them and their families when they come home and when they don't.
Ban AI voice impersonation?
That's why the song support and
Trump posted on True Social 15 minutes ago that drugs are wearing off. That's accurate.
Significant laws ever. Helping millions of veterans expose the toxin.
Epic.
Who now are battling more than 100 different cancers. Many of them don't come home, but we owe them and their families support. We owe it to ourselves to keep supporting our new health research agency called ARPA-H. And remind us.
Somebody should have brought Trump as a guest. That is what they should
have done. That's exactly right. That would have been awesome.
Marjorie's got the hat. Like, I'm not impressed by the hat. I want DJT in there staring down his opponent.
That would have been awesome.
In the front row.
Live with Trump reaction cam.
With the cane.
Yeah, with
that person's cane.
Solid gold one.
I know you don't want to hear any more, Lindsay, but I got to say a few more things.
Everybody just dunks on Lindsey Graham. Okay, you know what? All right. Biden W on that one, I have to say.
Certain things become clearer than ever.
Everybody just kicks him. Holy shit.
Again and again, I've seen the contest between competing forces in the battle for the soul of our nation.
Is he just going to take that?
Yes, of course he is.
A bitch slap.
My lifetime has taught me to embrace freedom and democracy, a future based on core values that have defined America, honesty, decency, dignity, equality, to respect everyone, to give everyone a fair shot, to give hate no safe harbor. Now other people my age see it differently. The American story of resentment, revenge, and retribution, that's not me. I was born amid World War II, when America stood for the freedom of the world. I grew up in Scranton, Pennsylvania, and Claymont, Delaware, among working-class people who built this country. I watched in horror as two of my heroes, like many of you did, Dr. King.
I think Kamala had to sleep with Joe Biden one time. No wonder she really resents him.
I left the law firm, became a public defender, because my city of Wilmington,
we know she would do it.
America occupied by the National Guard. After Dr. King was assassinated.
Just once.
I became a
counselor. All right, now that we're at the end of the vetting process,
I got elected to the United
come
States
to the old vetting coach. Get the old man one time.
Well, they tell me what you can do.
The president to the first women vice president.
That cane is coming out again. What the fuck? She hates Joe Biden, by the way. Yeah.
In my career, I've been told I was too young. By the way, they're going to let me on ascended elevators for votes sometimes. Not a joke.
Yeah. It's just a lie. Yeah, I know.
Too old. Whether young or old, I've always been known. I've always known.
As an idiot.
I drew my North Star. The very idea
Johnson
of
does kind of shine in this, like, smug, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
We've never fully lived up to that idea.
He does have a good smug
We've
face, you're right.
Walked away from it either. And I won't walk away from it now. I'm optimistic. I really am. I'm optimistic, Nancy.
Nancy chanting four more years. Is she going to be like 96 by then?
The issue facing our nation isn't how old we
four
are.
Four more years.
It's
good
how
Lord.
Old are our ideas.
Can you imagine?
Hate, anger, revenge.
He's not going to be alive four more years.
Ideas.
I can't.
But you can't lead America
with very old
ideas. Only take it back.
Yes, he's America extremely old.
Possibilities. You need a vision for the future and what can and should be done. Tonight you've heard mine. I see a future where defending democracy, you don't diminish it. I see a future where we restore the right to choose and protect our freedoms, not take them away.
Well, if Trump just walked in the door and strode down the friggin' aisle right now.
That's Donald Trump's music! What is he doing here?
Finally has a fair shot, and the wealthy have to pay their fair share in tax.
He doesn't even work here!
Throw me out. You're going to have to throw me out. I just came to say I'm very bored. Wrap it up, Joe. From gun violence. It's not doing good.
Above all.
The adrenochrome was wearing off 45 minutes ago.
I see a country for all Americans. I see a country for all Americans. And I will always be president for all Americans.
He just comes out of the side of the screen and gives Biden RKO right on the fucking...
You, the American people. You're the reason we've never been more optimistic about our future than I am now. So let's build the future
they
together.
They spray paint Trump over them.
We're the United States of America. And there is nothing, nothing beyond our capacity when we act together. God bless you all.
I know that was
God
it.
Protect our troops. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
About 1 hour, just like I said. Anything less than an hour for State of the Union, he would have to stay out there at least an hour. It was almost exactly an hour.
Johnson shakes his hand. What a quizzling.
Did he not shake Kamala's hand, by the way?
I think he did, but he's
okay, still, I just
he knows where it's been.
Well, that was the State of the Union.
Sucked.
The State of the Union sucks. It sucked. It was terrible. He mumbled, almost exclusively mumbled through the
I feel bad
half.
If you were watching that content without our Mystery Theater 3000, Mystery Science Theater 3000 style.
Dude, content. Thank you, by the way, for being here, because if I'd had to do this by myself, it's just...
I couldn't watch. I wouldn't even have watched it if I wasn't here. I just can't.
It's terrible. Trump, I'll look at some of his reacts in a minute. I don't know. Any thoughts on the speech overall?
Well, I think that the country is headed in the right direction. It was disturbing. The vacillating between the whispering and the shouting, as always, disjointed and weird. The fact that so many people have already died in these conflicts, Ukraine and Israel, just adds a morbid sensibility to it. AOC looking like the specter of death, like the Grim Reaper and the black. I mean, not a bad looking Grim Reaper, but you know, still kind of disturbing. Bernie and the mask. All in all, just bad content and cringe. And I didn't care for it. Thumbs down.
Thumbs down. Two thumbs down for me as well. Also, Bernie took off the mask just now. So what was the point of wearing the mask in the first? Okay. But he just took off the mask, I guess, for his photo op with Biden at the end. But then, okay, well, if you're going to take off the mask, what the fuck was the point of wearing it in the first place?
Said that many times.
That's just so dumb. Also, it was not even the N95 mask. Don't get me started. I don't even feel like that conversation. But, yeah, it was boring.
This is teaser. Going to see Spring Chicken Joe. He's got so much youth and vitality. When I was his age, I was ready to take on the world.
This young whippersnapper here.
He's the only guy who can make Joe look not ancient.
Holy shit. Tell people, I don't want to keep you all night. I'm
due back at the Smithsonian now, guys.
The one Madame Tussauds.
When Ben Stiller's the Watchman.
You're going to be doing a campaign show in the morning. Is that correct?
Yes, every morning from now until the campaign, even on the weekends, band.video and also on my Twitter. So you can go to patrickreports.com to get in touch with me, put in your email, and then you can get all my shows and everything. Smash that donate button if you'd like. There's a lot of campaign to cover. So, yeah, we're going to have a good show in the morning. And I got a book coming soon, and National File is where the reporting happens. So we're getting that amped up now pretty soon. So you got Trump, you got RFK, you got Creepy Joe, you got Cornel West. Don't think he's going to make the dark horse run, but he is going to take some votes probably away from Kennedy, really. And it's going to be fascinating. It's going to be very fascinating. And I like the dynamic of Trump and Kennedy having to run against each other. You know, I said, and I don't care if I get flack or not, I said, I'm undecided at this time because I want Trump to think that I am undecided at this time. Although I wouldn't take a vote away from Trump if he's the only one who can win. But let's see some competition between Trump and Kennedy, make them the best versions of themselves.
Yeah, and it looks like Kennedy's going to take the Libertarian Party nomination. I've been reading a little bit about that. So he should have ballot access in a lot more states than he currently has, which is like three or four, I think. And if he gets the Libertarian Party, I think he'll have ballot access in most states, like 40 to 45, something like that. So we'll see what happens with that. I appreciate you being so generous with your time and doing a little Mystery Science Theater, which I love to watch when I was a kid. Yes, those are the days.
Jon Stewart sucked on Comedy Central originally. Do you remember his original show? It was called Short Attention Span Theater. It was him and some chick. He was not funny. And now he's back in Comedy Central again being not funny, while Tucker Carlson is just like, you know, swinging big, so to say, nowadays, throwing down the Putin interview, you know. So Jon Stewart is lame, but
truly a change of fortune there between the two from that Crossfire takedown that Stewart did. And now Tucker is peacocking everywhere. And I think he's about to go live. We may cover some of that after you leave. But, again, I appreciate you spending time with us. It's a lot of fun watching it with you and bouncing off of each other here. And it would have been a real bore without you. So thank you.
All right. Peace to the world. Stop World War III. PatrickReports.com. Send me an email. See you next time, Ralph.
See you soon. Patrick Howley here live on the Killstream. Yes!
Thanks for watching this clip. This is Willow. Remember to like and subscribe.